As there doesn't seem to be very much information about these units online, today I thought I'd do a quick video on this JRC NJZ900A cellular tester. These were for testing analog phones back in the day. This one here, fairly straightforward. You've got your power switch, your 13.8 volt DC input, the two BNCs here, and the TRU interface. They're not required in the testing and the for what we use it for here. The RF input output connector and the connector for the test handset. If we take a look around the back. These connectors here don't really get used. Your fuse, DC output, and those two BNCs there. This little connector here is actually compatible with parallel port printers, so you can actually connect it up to any parallel port printer and it will output the test data. If you take a look on the top here, you can see it's very well manufactured. You've got your RF components here. All of these connectors are solid copper. And then here you've got all of your interface cards. They all just slot into the machine. Extremely well built. Looking at some of the date codes on here, it appears the machine was built sometime early 1990, maybe 1991. Plug back down in there. Now we'll turn the machine on. Here it goes through its self-check. And then you'll see ready once it's completed its test. Instructions here are pretty, not a lot of them, pretty straightforward. Relatively straightforward to work out what it's doing, especially with the call process simulation and that sort of thing, which we'll get to in a moment. So we can put our phone here and take the leads already connected to the antenna port on the phone. You can connect it to the test set. Time in about 17 years here in Australia, the phone is showing service. We'll do an auto test initially. Right. So to do an auto test, just press auto test there, and press start. You can see as it runs through the different testing steps, it prints them out the test won't go any further at this point without the interface connected. We can just press the reset button here to connect it. Gives you a rundown of the test data, the mobile service number, the ESN, power output, and the information up until we cancel the test. This is how we go about doing a call process simulation from this tester. As you can see from this Motorola bag phone handset, we currently have no service. This is how analog phones have been in Australia for about 17 years since they shut down the analog network in 2000. But turn the machine on, it will run through its self-test. And then it will come up ready. And at that point there, we have service on the phone here. So the mode we want is call process. The screen here, it defaults to voice channel 300 and a signal strength of minus 70. These parameters can be changed. For example, we can change the power output here by going across with the arrow keys. We can change it down to 115 dBm. That's a very, very low signal. Press enter. As you'll see, the bars on the phone have dropped to nothing. The highest, or the strongest signal we can output is minus 40. So if we put minus 40 and enter, you'll see the signal bars jump up to full strength. Now, to start the call process simulation, it's already in the call process mode. We just have to press start. The machine will register and bring up the mobile service number of the handset, and then it will be in idle mode, waiting for either a call to be transmitted or a call to be received. There's two ways to do this. We can initiate the call from the test set to the phone, or we can initiate a call from the phone to the test set. So in this first example, we'll call the phone from the test set. On the side of the handset, there's a rocker switch. Up is send, down is end. So if we hit send, see it's paging, the phone transmits, and then the call is received and answered. So from there, with the you can hear your voice through the handset, through the test handset, and through the phone itself. You can then, from the rocker switch on the right of the test handset, press down to end, the call will release, the signal will drop, and then the test set will return back into the idle mode. To initiate a test from the handset, there is a list of test numbers. They're fairly long, so that's those there. The main one you use is just for the voice. So the we press send on that, see the mobile number is, or the phone number dialed is transmitted. The phone itself is transmitting at almost 3 watts. The tester here is waiting for the call to be answered in origination. If we press the send button on the test handset, it will switch to talk mode. So you've got communication between the phone handset and the test handset. At this point here, you can adjust the power level in here. The same again, we'll try 90. So you can see how the phone behaves during the call with a change in power level. You can see the bars have dropped here. You can change the voice channel to simulate a handoff. And then once the call's ended, you can end the call. It will release and then return to the idle mode. I'll just run through the same call process simulation again, just with a different couple of different handsets. This is a Nokia C15 bag phone. Turn it on. Full service, and we can call process, start the test, it registers the service number, idle mode, and again we can page the, we can call the mobile handset. That's there, we're in talk mode. Same again, we can change the voice channel to simulate a handoff, and then we can change the signal strength during the call to simulate changing signal strength, and again we can end the call, it'll release and return to idle. Okay, in the final simulation today, we've got a actual analog or Motorola analog handset rather than a bag phone. So for this test, we've got a antenna connected to the RF output. So turn the handset on. And let's see, I've got a external power modifier battery put on there, because the actual original NiCad batteries are all leaked and died after 20 years. So there we are, we can see the roam light's on. The phone has picked up service from the antenna on the test set. So, and so call process. In this case here, because we're using the antenna, we'll put the power level at its highest. Start the test, the mobile number will register with the unit, idle mode, send on the test handset, paging, phone ring, in the flip phone we can just open, it goes to talk mode. And again, we can simulate a handoff. And then just being a flip phone, we can just close the flip, call releases, and it will return to idle.